Mellon Pompeo is one of the most famous and beloved and highest paid actresses of all time. Her award-winning portrayal of Meredith Grey on the hit show Grey's Anatomy has resonated with everyone who's ever watched the show. While her life off-screen doesn't involve saving lives, she does have an extraordinary life. To find out 10 things you didn't know about Ellen Pompeo, keep watching. And for the most surprising and mind-blowing fact, stay tuned until number 1. Number 10. She lived the New York dream. Kicking off our list, we have the origin story of how Ellen Pompeo was discovered. Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Cruel Intentions star Sarah Michelle Gellar was discovered while eating at a restaurant in New York. Hunger Games' Jennifer Lawrence was picked up at Union Square while on vacation. Vin Diesel and Rosario Dawson are also some of the few actors that were discovered on the streets of New York. Ellen Pompeo is one of the list of those who lived out the New York fairy tale dream. She was working as a bartender at the Soho Bar and Grill, and according to her, while she was a very good hustler, she was bad at mixing drinks. A casting director discovered her one night and asked her to appear in several ads for L'Oreal and Citibank. From there on out, she went on to appear in Law & Order as her TV debut in 1995. Her movie debut was in 1999 in the film Coming Soon. Other roles include guest starring on Strangers with Candy, Strong Medicine, Mambo Cafe, and most interestingly, she made an appearance on Friends. She appeared in the 10th season of the iconic series. Her character was Missy Goldberg, and she was a girl Ross and Chandler made a pact not to pursue. At number 9. Her early life is eerily similar to Meredith Grey. Ellen Pompeo's character, Dr. Meredith Grey, has lived through some pretty traumatizing hardships. But it turns out, some of the gut-wrenching events on the show are based on the actress's real life, so much so that fans called the writing cruel. So what are the similarities? Pompeo's mother tragically died in a painkiller overdose when Ellen was 4 years old. Meredith's mom attempted suicide at the same time. A few years later, Ellen's father would remarry. The same happened on the show. On the show, Meredith had 3 children, same as Pompeo. Like her character, or vice versa, Ellen struggled with fertility. In season 6, Meredith had a miscarriage and later, her fertility drugs made her temporarily blind. Pompeo struggled with difficult pregnancies. In the end, her daughter had to be born via a surrogate because of it. According to Pompeo, the writers of Grey's Anatomy feel that if the writing hits close to heart, the actors will give a more touching performance. Moving on to number 8. Grey's Anatomy will end when Ellen wants it to end. This sounds like a dream, your favorite TV show never ending. Grey's Anatomy currently has successfully run since its first episode in 2005. As of the making of this video, it's a whopping 17 seasons strong and still going. The show's genius creator, Shonda Rhimes, went on the record to say, "The show will go on as long as Ellen wants to do it." As the main protagonist, Grey's Anatomy is mostly centered on Pompeo's character, Dr. Meredith Grey. As long as Pompeo is ready to act out more emotional and medical trauma, Rhimes is ready to create more. However, on the fateful day Grey's Anatomy wraps up forever, Ellen Pompeo will probably retire as an actor as well. Yes, it will be a sad, sad day for TV indeed. In an interview in 2014, Pompeo said that she feels herself transitioning away from acting. She doesn't find acting terribly empowering, and she also doesn't find acting to be a particularly noble way to make a living. She stated that she's not actually saving anyone's life. And as she's not anything like a teacher or working for UNICEF, she doesn't believe that she's a big deal. Well, we think Ellen Pompeo's a big deal, and so do many people, as her mesmerizing role as Dr. Meredith Grey has touched many lives. In one incident, someone actually saved another person's life using CPR, as explained on the show. At number 7, she didn't audition for Dr. Meredith Grey. Typically, when an actor wants to try out for a role, they, well, audition. But that wasn't the case for Ellen Pompeo. She was auditioning for another show called Secret Service, which never got picked up. Instead, based on her audition, she was asked to star in Grey's Anatomy. You'd think Pompeo was fated to play that part. Surprisingly, young Ellen disagreed. Before her iconic TV role, she never wanted to be a TV star. At the time, she was getting praise for her performance in Moonlight Mile. While Grey's Anatomy was proposed to her, she rejected it right away, not wanting to be stuck on a medical show for 5 years. Thankfully, her agent stepped in and convinced her to do the pilot just to make some money for her rent. They both believed the series would never go on. 15 years later, and she's still playing the role. Checking in on number 6, Bizarre Childhood Nicknames. nearly everyone in the world suffered from a weird or embarrassing childhood nickname. Ellen Pompeo is the youngest out of six siblings, and all her siblings are at least 8 years older than her. It's not far-fetched to say she had a difficult childhood. A few of her childhood nicknames include The Pencil and Stroxatilla. The Pencil nickname in particular resonates even now that she's older. Over her career, Pompeo struggled with rumors and paparazzi, who criticized her figure and launched false rumors about how she had an eating disorder. At number 5, she only received $200 in the first episode. Pompeo only had a few roles under her belt when she started playing the lost but ambitious Dr. Meredith Grey. For the first few episodes in season 1, she only received a shocking amount of $200 per episode. Now, well, 17 seasons later, Grey's Anatomy is one of the longest-running TV shows of all time, and Pompeo takes home a whopping $575,000 every episode. In 2018, when Forbes did a piece on the highest-paid TV actors, Ellen Pompeo ranked as the third highest-paid actress, the highest-paid actress in a drama series overall, and as the fifth highest-paid actor in the industry. It's estimated that her yearly incomes are something like $23.5 million. Not only that, but she also gets a separate paycheck as a producer on the show. Almost a decade into playing the main character on Grey's Anatomy, Pompeo added something new to her contract when she was renewing it. She became a producer on the hit series and all its various spin-offs. This adds an extra $6 to $7 million to her yearly income. In addition, she has her own production company, Calamity Jane, that has produced 2 shows already. On to number 4. She doesn't like to do stunts. A lot of actors, like Law & Order's Mariska Hargitay or even Tom Cruise, insist on doing their own stunts. But that's not the case with Ellen Pompeo. While Grey's Anatomy is first and foremost a medical show with enough drama and romance to make you cry, there are some action and violent scenes involved. In 2006's episode, As We Know It, Meredith Grey had to surgically remove a bomb hidden inside a man's chest, then hand it to a bomb expert, who was played by Kyle Chandler. One thing went wrong, though. The bomb exploded. The explosion launched Meredith across the room. Originally, this scene and the thrown across the room part was supposed to be carried out by Pompeo's stunt double. Only, when they did the actual stunt, the stunt double was yanked back on her back. The snap her head made was painfully audible in the studio. She couldn't do the scene again, and on such short notice, despite originally not wanting to, the producers had Pompeo do the scene. They did pull her much slower than they did the stunt double. Moving on to number 3. She was once hit on by Jake Gyllenhaal. Now, this is more of a cheeky fact. Before Ellen Pompeo's fame skyrocketed due to her appearance on Grey's Anatomy, she worked on several other movies. One of them was 2012's Moonlight Mile, which she co-starred in with the famous Jake Gyllenhaal as his love interest and received high praise for. Before they were officially introduced as co-stars, they had an awkward encounter during which he unsuccessfully tried to hit on her. Keep in mind at the time, Jake Gyllenhaal was about 22 years old and Pompeo was 33. They bumped into each other, and he told her that she was the most beautiful thing he'd ever seen. Talk about a smooth talker. However, this pickup line was hit and miss. Pompeo ended up meeting her future husband later on in 2003, which leads us to our next point. Coming in at number 2, how she met her husband. Usually, Hollywood stars, especially ones famous as Ellen Pompeo, end up dating their co-stars or other people in the industry. But Ellen Pompeo was never one to follow the masses. She met the love of her life, Chris Ivory, who's a music producer, at a grocery store in Los Angeles, out of all places. The two of them bonded over being from Boston, and get this, it turned out they'd lived their entire lives a mere 10 miles away from each other. Just think about the odds of that happening. Despite their sweet meet-cute, they didn't end up dating until 6 months later. They got married in 2007. Pompeo didn't want a fancy party or anything over the top. Instead, she and Ivory tied the knot in a humble civil ceremony. Their only witness? The mayor of New York City, Michael Bloomberg. And number 1. Off-screen, Meredith Grey and Derek Shepherd didn't have the same McDreamy romance. And for our number 1 fact, we have the most shocking one of all. Every Grey's Anatomy fan is familiar with the heart-wrenching moment when Meredith walks up to the McDreamy doctor, Derek Shepherd, and declares her love for him. For 11 seasons, Pompeo and Derek's actor, Patrick Dempsey, mesmerized millions in their captivating and breathtaking love story. Despite their insane on-screen chemistry, their relationship was strictly professional, and they apparently didn't share a deep bond in real life either. While Pompeo has later stated that she doesn't hold a grudge or any hard feelings towards Dempsey. When she needed him most, her co-star didn't help her. Their friendship deteriorated when Pompeo wanted to negotiate her salary. Before that, she and Dempsey never spoke about their deals, but there was an insane pay gap. Dempsey was being paid double Pompeo's salary. The people behind the show really did Pompeo dirty at the time, considering the show is literally called Grey's Anatomy, and she plays Meredith Grey. Several times, Pompeo went to Dempsey for help and to ask him to join together and negotiate higher salaries, but he always refused. One time, they even refused her a $5,000 raise above his salary. In the end, Pompeo got her well-deserved raise to a staggering $23 million a year, and Dempsey left the show. In 2008, Pompeo revealed they haven't spoken in the years after he left. And that's a wrap on the 10 things you didn't know about Ellen Pompeo. Are you surprised at the facts? What'd you think? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Make sure to give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications to be notified next time we bring you another Celeb Glam Life video. Until then, goodbye.